Tonight, some new developments tied to the proposal to sell Pennsylvania's state stores. A former chairman of the Pennsylvania Liquor Control Board is coming out in support of the plan to turn wine and liquor sales over to private businesses. 8 on Your Side government reporter Matt Belanger has been staying on top of this story for us and has the latest. Matt?
And Brian, good evening. Debate among state lawmakers about this proposal to sell the state stores is really expected to heat up after lawmakers return to Harrisburg after Labor Day. But in the meantime, supporters continue to make their case.
And this is going to be our one chance in our generation to see the whole paradigm shift in Pennsylvania.
Jonathan Newman is a former chairman of the Pennsylvania Liquor Control Board, and he's now throwing his support behind high-ranking House Republican Mike Terzai's plan to sell off the state's wine and spirits stores, auctioning licenses to private businesses to sell booze instead.
The sale of wine and spirits on both a wholesale level and a retail level should be done by the private sector, who can do it best.
For private industry coming in, the state can profit.
Newman echoes Terzai's promises. Privatization will lead to a much-needed boost in cash for the state, plus better selection and lower prices for consumers. The plan would overhaul the state's liquor tax system, scrapping the 18% Johnstown flood tax Pennsylvanians are still paying, replacing it with a tax per gallon.
Even with the highest gallonage tax in the country, like a state like Florida, prices are going to come down dramatically, and private retailers are going to compete against each other.
The system does a great job for all Pennsylvanians.
But Wendell Young is perhaps the loudest opponent to the plan. He represents the unionized workers in the state-run stores. And among other criticisms, he disputes the claim wine and liquor prices will fall.
If this happens, there is going to be more taxes to be paid to make up for the revenue, and that's going to come from Pennsylvania taxpayers.
And I have tremendous empathy for 3,500 union employees. On the other hand, there are 12.4 million Pennsylvanians, and I think they have a right to good prices, beautiful stores, and this is going to create many jobs.
Now, this proposal still has a long way to go before it could become law, and if it passes the state house, its future in the state Senate isn't clear. Even some of Terzai's fellow Republicans who control the Senate say this issue is not a top priority in that chamber. Brian, back to you.
All right, Matt Belanger, thank you.